giant camera taking pictures, and I could have got fired. Any second somebody saw me, because we didn't have cell phones back then. You couldn't take, you know, covert photos, so I'm walking up there. But I usually did it like during the third shift or something when nobody was around. And I loved, you know, these gems were like pieces of sculpture to me. So this actually influenced the later series of art that I did, but the blueprint reading was the key to this job. Okay. Now, the other thing about the dog load is they allowed me to take classes on the schedule. So I started off taking, I was working during the day in the dog loads and taking night classes. So one of the first night classes I took was bronze casting. I wanted to learn how to cast, you know, molten bronze. And it just so happened that the gentleman right here was working with me on lowering the kiln over the ceramic, for the ceramic shell casting process. It's Claire Graham. And Claire Graham was only teaching one class part-time at the university at night. It was just bronze casting class. His real job was at the Disneyland Entertainment Art Department, which he managed. And so I became his right-hand man because, again, another process. It was like exciting, and it was new, and it was like, but nobody wanted to do it. None of the other students wanted to do this. It was hard work. It was hot. It was sweaty. It was dirty. So mostly everyone else stood around and watched Claire and I pour the bronze. But I'll tell you, again, not only the learning experience of doing it, firsthand, but the relationship that I formed with Claire. We became friends, he started throwing me freelance work. He said, hey, your name is the bronze making houses. And the university would let him use the foundry since he was, you know, he was teaching it part time. And I would end up helping him pour the bronze making houses, then I would clean them all up and make wooden bases and pass them off to him. It was an extra form of income. So then, my graduate school, okay, let's say now I'm changing. So this is my first bronze piece. And very different from the wood pieces that I did, you know, so I could explore a little more with the shape. But this piece was, you know, I, again, learning processes. I made it out of clay. I had to make a flexible mold, and then a hard mold. And then I had to take the clay out and pour the wax in, and add around the screw, the gate, the blue ceramic shell. A lot of people in the room probably doesn't mean anything about, you know, that process, but for me, learning that process was amazing to get from a clay to a finished bronze piece. Then I started combining materials, my biology. So I said, oh, okay, I want to do some stack lamination in bronze. So this obviously is the bronze in the middle and stack lamination here. But this was an engineering thing because I want this to be cantilevered out the side. That bronze piece is heavy. So this piece wants to fall. The top is hollow, the bottom is closed. So again, figured out engineering-wise, how do I make this work? The idea I had to figure out the engineering side. And then I did furniture back to the window, castle influence. I did what I call my anatomical series. Bronze and wooden, you know, going back to sort of my biology days and some of the shapes and forms, table and chair, all cast in bronze, exotic cardboards. And then I wanted to involve my friends in my work. I liked the idea of collaboration, so I'm like, how am I going to do this? And, you know, as a sculptor, all my sculpture was abstract. You know, I wasn't good at, you know, carving people's faces or drawing people's faces, but some people are, so I've seen some incredible work with some incredible sculptors. You know, capture the likeness of somebody's face. Not me. So I figured out how to do it. I'm going to take a mold of their face. So this is me with my probably former friends now, because after I did this to my friends, and I did it to more than just someone's divorce. But I was able to get the faces, and this is the end result of Claire's face in bronze, David, my studio partner, and in bronze on the other side, my face in acrylic resin. And the other thing that I did with this, I made that extension on my face and made the mold. I, aside from casting this one resin piece, I cast about half a dozen fiberglass pieces. Maybe I'll use these another piece down the road, and I do, we'll see. So this was that finished piece. And the irony of this piece was this started off to be a table. And it comes back to that, you know, looking at me differently. I had it, it just wasn't working for me as a table, wasn't working. So I flipped it over, and this sort of evolved. This was fun. Then for my master's thesis, you know, to get a thesis, you have to come up with you know, something that's relevant to your world, to your art. For me, it was money. It goes back to the biggest thing, how cool would it be to make a set of drums? And so, So I started off with this crude little model of planes. And the whole idea was that I'd make these shells that sort of organic, and they open up and project the sound out. And then this is the finished set made out of the Ibuya, which is a hardwood from Africa, and then the rims, So then, 1983, after 4 hard years, I got my Master of Fine Arts degree at California State University. And through the course of those 4 years, I started teaching part-time. I was eventually able to quit my job at McDonnell Douglas because I was getting a lot of freelance work from Disney. And I was teaching part-time at Long Beach State. So all of a sudden, and then as I got to the end, I had a full-time classroom. So there I was. I was being rich. I was, all of a sudden, I achieved my goal. I was a college professor teaching art, doing my art. It's like, wow, this is cool. So the rock star thing didn't work. The art star thing kind of worked. But now I'm actually a college professor. I'm where I'm going to be. And then Claire comes to me and says, how would you like to work for Disney? And I went, well, crap, that's what I was talking about, this fork in the road. You know, because I was never planning on working for Disney. And I thought, well, you know what? What happened to that thing now? I can always go back to teach. I thought, I got to try this. So I did. So I went to the Disneyland Entertainment Art Department, which if you take the first letter of each one of those, it spells out dead. So we were called the dead. You know, I went for freelance, which was a prime position at the Entertainment Art Department. But it wasn't for that much money. It was more about, okay, you're not Judy, you're Disney, try something new. And I'll tell you, it was the best thing I ever did because we did everything from bronze Mickey Mouse's to models for parade floats, Christmas parade here. We worked on the 1984 Olympics and how we would go to dress the Coliseum in LA. Movie premieres. We worked at all these movie premieres. Some flopped, some didn't. And then wacky things like the release of a million balloons. This was called Skyfest, which obviously could never be now. And but it was unbelievable. And for all this stuff, we were pulling all-nighters all the time. I mean, it was an exhaustive job. And then through it, because of the networking, it was meeting all these people in the entertainment industry. So I ended up getting involved in TV specials and TV commercials. And again, nothing that I ever planned on doing, just sort of all unfolded. I Gallagher, this is a comedian. I was the assistant art director on this HBO special. And his shit was, he smashed it in watermelon. He sells people covered in plastic. And so they ended up with, you know, watermelon guts all over the place. It was crazy, but David Sakharov was the art director, I was the assistant art director, and I helped him build the whole set, build and install the whole set. And that was fun. This thing came up, and I was still working full time for Disney, but I was taking some on the side. TV commercials, this was an IBM commercial. And I, again, worked on this set piece and stuff. And this gentleman right here, Ed Martin, was the cinematographer. And his wife, Sandy, was actually the producer of commercials. And I ended up, Maureen and I both ended up being really good friends with Ed and Sandy. They're great people. And then Sandy comes to me and said, look, Ed's birthday's coming up. I want you to take a moment of his space and do an art piece of Ed. So I did. So I ended up, this is Ed in this car, an art piece that's on the wall now. And then the other thing that was really cool about this goes back to relationships, networking, and another fork in the road. So Sandy says to me, look, there's a lot of work in LA. Do you want to get a TV business? Do you want to work on commercials? You can have tons of work. But you can't live in Long Beach. And Long Beach is like 30 miles south of LA. So you've got to live in LA. So I said, okay. So you know what? Quit Disney. And I said, I'm going to do it. I'm going out on my own. Take it a risk. So I left Disney and decided to start my own company. So I did a doing business hours, Larry A. Designs, and I took on all sorts of wacky things, you know. But to do it, I had to set up shop in downtown LA, and that friend, the studio partner, who at the time was trying to get a studio space in downtown LA. She said, I found this big empty warehouse. There's a sink and a toilet in it, that's all. You want to go in the studio with me? She was only going to use it on the weekend. I said, well, I'm going to do it. I'm going to live there. So I moved into, this is when I brought the first three grades. This was the loft here upstairs on the top floor. And this is a pile of stuff. We started to build this studio space out. And the thing was, when we do these commercials, we would build these sets. And because it was a one-time shoot, you do the shoot, it goes in the dumpster. And so now, instead of going in the dumpster, it all started going back in my pickup truck. And so all of this stuff, so I literally built out my studio from stuff that I had collected from doing all these TV things. And so this is me in the process of dividers and building walls and building platforms. I built a kitchen, I built a shower, I put a dark room in. And this was my studio and my living space. And it was fun. It was a great